Have you heard from the fluter of the town of Ballymuck? Times are growing hard with him, in fact the man was broke. He just sent out a notice to the neighbors one and all, as how he'd like their company that evening at a ball. And when writing out, he was careful to suggest to them, if they found a hat of his convenient to the door, the more they put in whenever he requested them, the better would the music be for battering in the floor. With the toot and the flute and the twiddle of the fiddle-oh, popping in the middle like a herrin on the griddle-oh, up, down, hands around, crossing to the wall. Oh, hadn't we the gaiety of Phil the Fluter's ball? There was Mr. Denis, Doherty, who kept the running dog, little crooked Paddy from the Tiraloughett bog, boys from every barony and girls from every art, the beautiful Miss Brady in a private Aston cart. Along with them came the bouncing Mrs. Cafferty, little Millie Mulligan was also to the fore, Rose Suzanne and Margaret O'Rafferty, the flower of Tipperary and the pride of Petrovore. With the toot and the flute, the twiddle of the fiddle-oh, hopping in the middle like a herrin on the griddle-oh, up, down, hands around, crossing to the wall. Oh, hadn't we the gaiety of Phil the Fluter's ball? Then Phil the Fluter tipped a wink to little crooked Pat. I think it's nearly time, says he, for passing round the hat. So Patty passed the cobbing round and looking mighty cute, says you've got to pay the piper when he's twiddling on the flute. All joined in with the greatest joviality, covering the buckle and the shuffle and the cut. Cheeks were danced of the very finest quality, the wit a bet the company at handle in the foot. With the toot and the flute and the twiddle on the fiddle-o, hopping in the middle like a herrin on the griddle-o, up, down, hands around, crossing to the wall. Oh, hadn't